We gather in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, especially to those who have just arrived, I would again would like us to welcome to the Manila Cathedral the replica of the cross of Wawa in Bukawe, Bulacan. It is an honor and privilege for us to be chosen by the parish of Bukawe to bring the replica here, and the cross will stay here until May 31. And as during these days, as I said earlier, I hope these days will be days of grace and days during which people who are carrying burdens in their lives may find consolation through the cross. To prepare ourselves for this Eucharistic celebration, let us acknowledge that we are all sinners in need of God's mercy. Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you come in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you will come again in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who willed that your only begotten Son should undergo the cross to save the human race, grant, we pray, that we who have known his mystery on earth may merit the grace of his redemption in heaven. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the letter of Saint James. Do not complain, brothers and sisters, about one another, that you may not be judged. Behold, the judge is standing before the gates. Take as an example of hardship and patience, brothers and sisters, the prophets who spoke in the name of the Lord. Indeed, we call blessed those who have persevered. You have heard of the perseverance of Job, and you have seen the purpose of the Lord, because the Lord is compassionate and merciful. But above all, my brothers and sisters, do not swear, either by heaven or by earth, or with any other oath, but let your yes mean yes, and your no mean no, that you may not incur condemnation. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is kind and merciful.
The Lord is kind and merciful.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all my being. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits.
The Lord is kind and merciful.
He pardons all your iniquities. He heals all your ills. He redeems your life from destruction. He crowns you with kindness and compassion.
The Lord is kind and merciful.
Merciful and gracious is the Lord, slow to anger and abounding in kindness. He will not always chide, nor does he keep his wrath forever.
The Lord is kind and merciful.
For as the heavens are high above the earth, so surpassing is his kindness toward those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far as he put our transgressions from us.
The Lord is kind and merciful. Please stand.
Your word, O Lord, is truth. Consecrate us in the truth.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus came into the district of Judea and across the Jordan. Again, crowds gathered around him, and was as his custom, he again taught them. The Pharisees approached him and asked, "Is it lawful for a husband to divorce his wife?" They were testing him. He said to them in reply, "What did Moses command you?" They replied, Moses permitted a husband to write a bill of divorce and dismiss her. But Jesus told them, "Because of the hardness of your hearts, he wrote you this commandment. But from the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, no human being must separate." In the house of the disciples again, or in the house, the disciples again questioned Jesus about this. He said to them, "Whoever divorces his wife and marries another commits adultery against her. And if she divorces her husband and marries another, she commits adultery." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Kung ang isang tao, Hudyo o Romano o Hintil o Pagano, na nabuhay nung panahon ni Jesus, ay pupunta ngayon dito sa ating simbahan, magkakaroon ng parang time travel, no? O time machine, at makita niya na sa harap natin ay nakadisplay ang krus, magtataka siya. Magtataka siya sapagkat nung panahon ni Jesus, ang krus ay sagisag ng kahihiyan. Ang isang kriminal na pinarusahan ng kamatayan sa krus nung panahon ni Kristo ay masasabing pinakamasamang kriminal. It's an extreme punishment. That is why Romans, the citizens of Rome, were not given this kind of punishment. Eh tayo hindi. Naka-display ang krus. Yung iba sa inyo, merong pendant ng krus. Ang rosary natin ay may krus. Kayo ba gagawin yung pendant ang electric chair? Gagawin yung pendant yung lubid na yung pang bitay? Hindi. The cross is not only a symbol, but in reality, the punishment that one can give to a criminal na sasabihin natin talagang halang ang kaluluwa. Pero bakit natin pinagpupugayan ang krus? Bakit natin ginagamit ang krus katulad ng aking chasuble bilang symbol? Kasi ganyan katalino ang Diyos. Sa kanyang katalinuhan, ginamit niya ang isang instrumento ng kahihiyan at kamatayan bilang instrumento ng kaligtasan at kaluwalhatian. Dahil sa pagkamatay ni Jesus sa krus, yung dating instrumento ng kahihiyan ay naging instrumento ng pagliligtas. Yan ang dahilan kung bakit tayo nagpupugay sa krus. Yan ang dahilan kung bakit isinusuot natin bilang pendant ang krus. Sapagkat tinitignan natin ang krus hindi lamang bilang simbolo ng kamatayan, kundi bilang sagisag ng pagliligtas ng Diyos. At dahil dito, dalawa ang nais kong bigyang pansin. Una, kung may dumarating na krus sa buhay natin, hindi naman natin dapat ipagdasal eh, no? Lord, bigyan mo ako ng krus. Lord, masyadong payapa ang buhay ko. Bigyan mo ako ng krus. Wala namang gagawa nun. Kung dumating ang krus sa buhay natin, tanggapin natin ito. Yakapin. Hindi dahil tayo mga sadista, kundi isipin natin na ito'y ibinibigay sa atin, hindi dahil natutuwa ang Diyos na tayo ay nakikitang naghihirap, kundi dahil alam ng Diyos na mula sa paghihirap na ito ay mahuhugot natin ang kaligtasan. Huwag nating iwasan ang krus kapag ito'y dumating. Huwag nating talikuran ang krus sapagkat may halaga ang krus sa ating ikababanal. Ngayon po, panahon ng graduation. Sino yung gagraduate? Sino yung aakyat sa stage at tatanggap ng diploma? Yun yung nagtiis na pumasok kahit na mainit ang classroom, gumawa ng assignment at projects, nagtiis na makinig sa teacher kahit boring ang teacher, hindi sumuko, hindi huminto. Kaya yung diploma ay bunga ng kanyang pagsusumikap. Yung diploma ay simbolo ng kanyang pagtsitsaga. Ang diploma ay instrumento na nagpapakitang siya'y nag-aral ng mabuti. Ganon din ang krus. Ibinibigay ng Diyos ang krus sa atin sapagkat alam niyang mula sa krus na ito ay magkakaroon tayo ng kaligtasan. Tamang-tama po ang ebanghelyo natin at maging ang ating unang pagbasa. Sa unang pagbasa, sinasabi ni Santiago na yung ating perseverance, no? Blessed are those who have persevered, sabi niya. Yung ating pagtsitsaga, yung ating hindi pagsuko ay pwedeng maging daan ng pagpapala. At sa ebanghelyo, tamang-tama yung ebanghelyo natin dahil ngayon ay issue ang divorce, ang proposed bill sa Pilipinas. Ipapasok ang diborsyo sa kaisipan ng Pilipino. Ito ang payo ko sa mga mag-asawa. Tinanggap ninyo ang isa't isa. Alam ninyong hindi perpekto ang isa't isa. Nagpakasal ba kayo ng biglaan? Hindi ba't ito'y inyong pinag-isipan? Pinaghandaan? Sana pinaghandaan ninyo ang inyong kasal. Pero bakit kapag dumating na yung mga hirap ng pagsasama, kapag dumating na yung mga pabigat na ugali, agad-agad tayong susuko? Agad-agad tayong aalis? Agad-agad tayong bibitiw? At ngayon, kung maging batas na ang diborsyo sa Pilipinas, meron na tayong exit. Meron na tayong emergency exit. Ang iisipin ba natin ay, sige, magpapakasal ako anyway, kung hindi naman kami magkasundo, may diborsyo naman. So, ganun na. We have a way out. So ayaw na nating mahirapan. ayaw na nating magtiis. Gusto natin ng lagi madaling buhay. Eh siguro, nasanay na kasi tayo sa mga instant. May instant coffee, may instant sabaw ng sinigang, may instant text, may instant this, instant that. Kaya tuloy, lahat gusto natin madali. Pero pinaaalaala sa atin ng krus, sa buhay, hindi lahat makukuha sa madalian. Hindi lahat mapapasa atin ng hindi paghihirapan. That is the first reminder to us of the cross. The second is this. Kapag nakikita ninyo ang kapwa ninyong nagpapasa ng krus, kung talagang deboto tayo sa krus, dapat maging kaagapay tayo ng ating kapwa sa pagpapasan niya ng krus. Napansin ko dito sa ating harapan ay may dalawang imahen. Siniguro ko kay Father Rich, ito'y imahen ng Mater Dolorosa at ni San Juan. Silang dalawang naiwan sa krus. Hindi iniwan ang Panginoon. Hindi katulad ng ibang mga alagad, nung si Jesus ay wala na, dinakip na, no? Nag-alisa na. Iniwan si Jesus. Mga ginigilig kong kapatid, ang tunay na pagdidebosyon sa krus ay yung pagsama, pag-agapay sa kapwa natin na merong pinapasan. Oo, maaaring may pinapasan din tayo. May problema din tayo. May mga pagsubok din tayong pinagdadaanan. Pero hindi natin iniiwan ang ating kapwa o pinababayaan sa kanyang pagpapasan ng krus. Sana yan ang maging isang bunga ng ating pagdidebosyon sa krus, na yung kapwa nating nagpapasan ng krus ay hindi natin pababayaan at iiwang nag-iisa. Hilingin natin ang awa ng mahal na Poon na nagpasan ng krus at namatay sa krus dahil sa atin. Hilingin natin na sa pamamagitan ng kanyang awa ay magawa nating yakapin ang ating mga krus ng maluwag sa ating loob at magawa nating tulungan ang kapwa nating may pinapasan ding krus. Amen.
Please all stand.
Let us continue praying for rain. God, our loving Father, Creator of our earth and of the universe, and of all the wondrous stay in your living creatures.
We humbly ask you to grant us relief from the extreme heat that besets your people at this time, disrupting their activities and threatening their lives and livelihood. Send us rain to replenish our depleting water sources, to irrigate our fields, to stave off water and power shortages, and to provide water for our daily needs. At your command, the wind and the seas obey. Raise your hand, Almighty God, to avert the continuing rise in temperatures so that your people can engage in productive undertakings and our young people can pursue learning in tranquility and comfort. Merciful and generous God, open our eyes to the richness and beauty of your creation and instill in us a deep love for this earth and all that is in and around it. Teach us to be wise stewards of your creation so that we may always use them responsibly and protect them from abuse and exploitation. At this time of crisis, dear Lord, move us to share more to serve more, and to love more. Loving God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, you entrusted the Filipino people to the special care of Mary, our Mother. Listen to the prayers that we bring up to her, our Blessed Mother, to intercede for us, for the protection of our land and our people, whom she loves.
Grant this to our Lord Jesus Christ,
Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you
in the unity of the Holy Spirit,
God, forever and ever. Amen.
Our Lady of Guadalupe,
pray for us.
Saint Rose of Lima,
pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us. Please be seated.
Pray, my dear sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
May this oblation, O Lord, which on the altar of the cross canceled the offense of the whole world, cleanse us, we pray, for all our sins, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you placed the salvation of the human race on the wood of the cross, so that where death arose, life might again spring forth, and the evil one who conquered on a tree might likewise on a tree be conquered through Christ our Lord. Through him, the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore, and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exultation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please all stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with Saint Martin of Tours, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. As one family with one common Father in heaven, we pray. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our many sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Matulog
kaloob at pagsasalo wala.
Please all stand.
Let us pray. Having been nourished by your holy banquet, we beseech you, Lord Jesus Christ, to bring those you have redeemed by the wood of your life-giving cross to the glory of the resurrection, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
I would like to thank Father Rich and his parish priest who is not with us, Father Mar, and the people of Bukawe, Bulacan, for coming to the Manila Cathedral and bringing the replica of the cross of Wawa that will be staying here until May 31. So, salamat po sa inyong pagdalaw. Palakpakan po natin ang mga taga Bukawe. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Eucharist has been offered. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.